Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In the last sessions we have seen how to create a data table, how to sort the data, how to remove duplicates and how to add extra rows or extra columns to an existing data table. So in this session we are going to discuss about filtering the data table. So here in UiPath Studio we can filter the data from a data table with the help of an activity called filter data table. So here we can filter the data in a logical way. So we'll see how we can perform this activity. So for that, first go to the activities bar. So I have already created one data table, so which we are using previously. So and I have modified this table with marks and I added the details to all the students. Okay, so in the activity, search for the activity called filter data table. So here we have, so just drag and drop into our designer panel. It is filter table. We need filter data table. So as we are dealing with the data tables, so we need to have this activity. So if you observe this activity, we have a button called filter wizard. So if you open this wizard, so we can see the fields. So which is asking for the input data table, output data table, filter rows and output columns. So with the help of this filter wizard, we can filter the data in two ways, either by using the rows or either by using the columns. So here what we need to do is, so first we need to provide the data table. So here I have the data table called DT. So I'm going to provide the details here. So it contains the details of the students. So what I will do is I'll take a screenshot of our data. So I have the data like this with the student name, roll number, marks as the column names. So here what we need to do is in the filter wizard, so we can either keep the data or remove the data from the data table. So with the help of these radio buttons. So if you want to keep the data, just select as keep. So how it behaves is, so when we keep the data, if you want to perform the operation on marks, so for suppose I have a column, so here we need to provide the column names for suppose like marks, so and the operation. So whether, so here we have the marks for example. So I want to filter, keep the data of the Sebastian who is having the value as 750. So I just want to get the Sebastian details. So for that what I will do is, so for marks I will use the operation as equals and I will provide the value as 750. So now if I perform this activity, I will get the details of the Sebastian. So here the output of this will be stored as a data table. So here I will create one more variable. So I will do as filter DT. Okay, so this is our output variable. So let's see how the output is. So for printing this output, so we need to use the activity. So output data table. So here as we discussed earlier, it will take the input of the data table. So here I am going to keep the filter DT as my input. So and it will give the output in the form of text. So I am keeping a variable as value. So I am going to print this in my output panel. So for that I will use write line activity. So here my input will be the variable which is the output of our output data table. So let's see. So here in the filter wizard we kept the condition like, so marks equals to 600. Okay, so let's run this. So here we go. So we got the output saying the student name, roll number, marks and showing the Sebastian 66 and 750. 66 is his roll number and marks equals to 750. So here it is satisfying the condition. Okay, so filter the wizard. So in the same way, if you want to delete this wizard member from the list, so just select as remove. So now the Sebastian will be not present in the list, and it will display the whole result into our output panel. Okay, so let's run this now. So here we got the result except Sebastian. So here we can see the result. So here after Leo, Queen and Mark, Sebastian is present, but in our output panel we don't see Sebastian anywhere. So like this we can filter the data from a data table in row wise, and in coming to the output columns, so here we will see the fields like keep or remove. So here we will write one condition. So like I just want to see the details of the student name and marks. So for that what I will do is I don't need the roll number, so I will remove this. So I'll mention the column name which I don't want to see in my output data table. So roll number is the column I don't want to see, so here I'm keeping it under remove. So just click on OK. I'm running this process. So now we should be able to see only the marks and the student details without the table of the roll numbers. Okay. So here we can see the column is not available in the output panel. So we got only the student name and the marks. We can see the details also with the column names. Okay. So and another thing is, so here if you want to provide the more details, suppose you just need to click on plus and plus. So whatever the columns you want to keep or you want to remove, you can do it here. And in the filter, if you add one more row, so here we can give the conditions. Like if suppose if I want to filter, so only the details of a couple of persons. So for example, I just want to get the details of Leo and Sebastian. So here for Sebastian, we write the condition as marks equals to 750, and here I will do one thing. So if you want to change the condition, by default the condition will be an AND. So just like our Boolean operations, so here also it is based on AND or, only these two operations are available here. So just click on OR. So I'm going to display the two values. So one record belongs to the Leo, one record belongs to the Sebastian. So here what I will do is I will use the column name as student. So who is, so here we can see the conditions. So contains the name as Leo. Okay, just click on OK. So now this filter showing some error, so that column textbooks cannot be empty. It's not empty. Okay, I think we need to remove this. Okay, that's it. Okay, let's run this. So here as per our requirement, so I need to see the member records who is having the mark 750 and the student name contains Leo. So as it is our condition, both the results will get displayed. Okay, so let's run this. Yeah, here we are not getting the result properly. So why? Because so we selected the remove operation, so those two records got removed. So I will keep the keep button now, so we see the result. Yeah, I think the execution is completed. Yeah, here we go. So we got the details of Leo and the Sebastian, so which is satisfying our condition. So in the same way, if you want to perform the operation of AND also, we can do it. So here I will change the condition to AND. So as we don't have any details which are satisfying the both the condition, so here is student name is Leo and the marks is 750, but our student Leo is with the score of 823. So we won't see any result in our output panel. So let's run this. Okay. And see, we can see the result here in the output panel. So we got only the column names. Why? Because so we don't have any person with the same score as Leo, who is score with the 750. So that's why we are not seeing any result in our output panel. So like this. So we can also print the data into our Excel sheet with the rate with the help of write Excel activities or write range activities. So which we already discussed in the previous lecture. So if you want to perform the activity on Excel sheet, so just refer that tutorial once. And I hope you like this video. Please do subscribe to my channel for more videos on UiPath and testing related tools. Thank you so much.